So this week we are going over several principles that you're probably going to use in the rest of the semester. The first principle, the main principle that we have to talk about, is the principle of opportunity costs. You probably have never taken a class in economics, you probably heard about opportunity costs. Even if you have never taken a class in economics, you probably have heard about the concept of opportunity costs. But you deal with the concept of opportunity costs every time, all the time in your life. Think about the opportunity costs of you watching this lecture. Well, economists think about opportunity costs as the value of the next best alternative you have when you do something or when you buy something, right? So for instance, the opportunity cost of you spending your precious time watching me here talk to you could be what you would be doing instead if you were not watching me here talking to you. What would you be doing? Well, it's different for each of you. Some of you might be like to take a walk on the beach, maybe you want to watch a movie, play a game of basketball with your friends, study for your class, work, right? So if you're using your time to do to watch me, you're probably not going to be able to do those other things. So whatever thing you will be doing with your time, if you're not watching this lecture, that will be the opportunity cost of you watching this lecture. Now, this concept is the central concept of economics, and it looks like a really simple concept, but as a very famous economist said, the beauty of this concept of opportunity cost is that it's perfectly simple without being perfectly obvious. And let me give you an example of that. Here's a question that that we usually present to people, to students on opportunity cost. And there's a little story about this question that I'm going to tell you in a second. But first, I want to see if you can actually, now that you know what opportunity cost is, if you can actually answer the question correctly. So suppose you actually have, you want a free ticket to see Eric Clapton concert, and assume that it has no resale value. Assume that Bob Dylan and other musicians, famous musicians, is performing on the same night, and it's your most attractive alternative. If you didn't go to see Clapton, you will see Dylan. If you don't see Dylan, you will see Clapton. Now, tickets to see Dylan cost about $40, but you're willing to pay $50 to see him. And assume that for the Kansas City, there's no other costs of seeing each performer. Now, based on this information, what would be the opportunity cost of seeing Eric Clapton? And I'm going to give you five choices. Is the opportunity cost of seeing Eric Clapton 0? Is it 10? Is it 40? Is it 50? Or is it none of the above? With the information we gave you, which one of these is the opportunity cost of seeing Eric Clapton? So take a second, try to answer on your own, and then we go over the answers here. All right, so let's summarize all this information we have here. So what the information I'm giving you is that the value to see Dylan that you get is $50, and that the cost to see Dylan is $40. There's no other cost, and if you don't see Clapton, you'll see Dylan, and if you see Dylan, you'll see Clapton. So the only two alternatives you have tonight. If you go to see Clapton, how much are you giving up? Well, to think about the opportunity cost, the definition is that the value you give up of your best alternative. So let's say you don't see Clapton, go to see Clapton, and you go see Dylan. Well, how better off you are if you go see Dylan? Well, you're willing to pay $50 to see him, but you have to pay $40 to see him. So after you see Dylan, in dollar terms, you're better off 10, right? It's like you want to buy a hamburger and the store, and the burger costs $5, and you're willing to pay $10. After you buy the burger, you're better off by $5. I mean, you have the burger, but you don't have the $5 you pay to get the burger. So you only have the $5 extra that you didn't have to pay to get the burger. That's your surplus, that's your value, right? So the same thing here. If you go to see Dylan, how better off you are? Well, you're willing to pay $50, you only pay $40, so you're better off $10. If that's the value you get if you go see Dylan, if you don't see Dylan, how much you lose? $10. Because if that's the value you get if you go see Dylan, if you don't see him and you see Clapton, you're giving up the $10. So that is the opportunity cost of seeing Clapton. It is $10. It's $10. That's the answer. There's no other answer. Now, to give you an idea of how difficult this concept of opportunity cost could be, well, I don't know how many of you actually thought what the answer was 10. But when I have given this question to my students, and I've given this question to thousands of students across the U.S., and we have calculated the percentage of students who get it right in the first time, we actually found out that about 7% of students who have taken a class in economics are able to answer this question correctly. which tells you a lot about how good economic classes are out in the US, but also tells you a lot about how difficult this concept is. Now, an interesting fact is that when we ask this question to thousands of students who have never taken an economics class, they do better. About 18% of them get it right. We again tells you a lot about the confusion about opportunity costs, and perhaps even more confusing when you're exposed to the concept. So this is actually, this is a question of opportunity costs. It's a very interesting question because it's simple without being obvious. So I'm gonna give you a lot more questions on opportunity costs. But the idea of opportunity costs, remember, is simple, but it's not obvious. And hopefully that will be one thing that you'll notice as we progress through the course. Now, we're going to use this concept of opportunity costs probably in the next principle we talk about, which is net marginal benefits.
Produced by OCE Atlas Digital Media at the University of Illinois, Urbana-Champaign.